Hi friends, welcome to Kraku's video series. I'm Saili Kale. I'm one of the co-founders of Kraku and an alumna of IIM Ahmedabad. In today's video, we'll be discussing two CAT questions that came from the topic of geometry. Geometry is one of the most important topics in CAT. It is one of those topics where if you put in regular effort, you will do well. So it's very important to first know what is asked in CAT, what level of difficulty of questions are asked in CAT. And secondly, to put in regular practice by solving these questions and knowing all the concepts that are related to geometry. So let's take a look at these questions. Let's take a look at the following question that appeared in CAT 2018. Let ABCD be a rectangle inscribed in a circle of radius 13 cm. Which of the following pair can represent in centimeter the possible length and breadth of ABCD? So we have a circle of radius 13 cm. And we have ABCD that is inscribed inside the circle. So all the angles of a rectangle are 90 degrees. And if you know the basic properties of a circle, you know that only the diameter subtends a right angle at the circumference. So if ABCD is a rectangle, then BD must be the diameter of the circle. What is the length of the diameter? Length of the diameter is 2 times 13, that is 26 centimeters. So we know that this is 26 centimeters. So we have to find values of AB and AD such that BD can be 26 centimeters. So we know that this is 90 degrees. So this is also a right angle triangle. So BD square will be AD square plus AB square. So we just have to figure out pairs of AB and AD such that sum of their squares is equal to 26 square. So what is 26 square? 26 square is 676. So we have to find out pairs whose squares is 676. So consider 24 and 10. The last digit of 24 square will be 6. The last digit of this will be 0. So the last digit of their sum will be 6. So this is a possibility. Consider this 25. The last digit will be 4. Last digit of 9 square is 81, that is 1. So the sum of these squares will be, last digit will be 6. So it's a possibility. In this case, last digit will be 5, last digit will be 0. So the sum of the squares, last digit will be 5. So this is not a possibility. In this case, last digit will be 6, last digit will be 4. Sum of their squares, the last digit will be 6 plus 4, that is 0. So again, this is not a possibility. So these are the two possible cases. What is 24 square? 24 square is 576. And 10 square is 100. So we can see that for a rectangle of side 24 and 10, the diagonal would be 576 plus 100, that is 676. So the required equation is satisfied. So A equal to 24 and so AB and BD, the two pairs, this pair represent one possible case where this rectangle can be inscribed in a circle of radius 13 centimeters. So the right answer is option A. Now let's go on to the next question. A right circular cone of height 12 feet stands on its base, which has diameter 8 feet. The tip of the cone is cut off with a plane which is parallel to the base and 9 feet from the base. With pi equal to 22 by 7, the volume in cubic feet of the remaining part of the cone is what? So you have this, this is given, it's given that this is 12 feet. So this length is 12 feet. This base diameter is 8 feet. So this is 4 feet in radius. So what is the volume of the uncut part? Volume of the uncut part would be V1 is 1 by 3 pi r square h. So this is equal to 1 by 3 times pi into r square is 8 into 4 into h is 12. So this is 16 into 12. So this is again 4. So this is 16 into 4, 64 pi. So this is the volume of the uncut cone. Now you're going to make a cut 9 feet from the base of this. So if this is 9 feet, this will be 3 feet. So height of the cut cone, so that tip will also be a cone in itself. So because if this is 3 feet, by using the concept of proportionality theorem, these two triangles, say this is ABC and this is PQ, if it is cut parallel to the base, triangle APQ will be similar to triangle ABC. Because PQ will be parallel to BC, these two angles will be equal because they are corresponding. Similarly, these two angles will be equal because they are corresponding. So, using the concept of similarity of triangles, since it is cut 3 feet at 3 feet height, this will be essentially 1/4 of the entire height of the frustum. So, all lengths will be 1/4. So, this length, this radius of this base will also be 1/4. So, this will be 1 foot. So, what is the volume of this cut part? So, volume of the cut portion will be 1/3 into pi r dash square into h dash. H dash is 3 feet, r dash is 1 foot. So, this is equal to 1/3 into pi into 1 square into 3. So, this is equal to pi as such. So, what is the value of the remaining part? Value of the remaining part is V1 minus V cut, that is the part that was cut off, volume of the uncut portion minus the part that was cut off, that is 64 pi minus pi. So, this is equal to 63 pi. 63 pi, pi is 22 by 7. So, we have 63 into 22 by 7. So, this is 9 times. So, 9 times into 22, that is 9 into 11, that is 99 into 2, that is 198 cubic feet. So, feet cube. So, the volume of the remaining part would be 198 cubic feet. So, this is the answer that is required. We found that value for the volume of the remaining part by first finding the volume of the original cone, then the volume of the cut portion. Subtracting the volume of the cut portion from the original part, we got the volume of the remaining part as such. It's very important that when you cut something parallel to the base, you are essentially forming a smaller version of the original cone, and everything will be in proportion to the original cone. So, if the height is 1/4 of the height of the original cone, then the base will also be 1/4, everything slant height will be 1/4, everything would be in the same proportion as such. It's important to remember that and the fact that you needed to know the volume formula for cube and for a right circular cone, and then you could easily solve this question. Now, let's take a look at the another question from geometry. Given an equilateral triangle T1 with sides 24 centimeter, a second triangle T2 is formed by joining the midpoints of the sides of T1. So, let's draw this out. So, you have this triangle which is an equilateral triangle, then you join the midpoints of the sides and you get this is T1, this is T2, and then a third triangle T3 is formed by joining the midpoints of sides of T2. If this process of forming triangles is continued, the sum of the areas in square centimeters of infinitely many such triangles T1, T2, T3 will be what? So, let's first find the area of T1. Area of T1, it's an equilateral triangle with side 24 centimeters. So, that is root 3 by 4 into 24 square. So, this is the value of the side of the triangle. Now, what would be the area of T2 with respect to T1? See, if you join the midpoints like this, this is midpoint, this is, all of these lengths are the same. And this is 60 degrees, this is 60 degrees. So, this length will also be the same. So, essentially, now we have four equilateral triangles, each of side which is half the side of the original triangle. So, what would be the area of T2? Area of T2 would be, now the length of T2 is half the length of each side of T2 is half the length of the original triangle. So, that would be root 3 by 4 into 24 by 2 the whole square. So, this is essentially root 3 by 4 times 24 square into 1 by 4. When you repeat the process, again you get 1/4 of the original triangle, because again you are splitting up the original triangle into 4 equal parts. So, each time you are splitting, successive triangle will be 1/4 of the previous triangle. So, if you add up all their areas, what do you get? You get essentially sum of areas is equal to root 3 by 4 times 24 square into, for T1 it is 1, for T2 it is 1/4, for T3 it is 1/4 into 1/4, that is 1/16. And so on. So, this is essentially a GP with the first term as 1 and constant ratio as 1 by 4. So, for a sum to infinity of this kind of a GP would be A divided by 1 minus R. So, this is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus 1 by 4. So, this is equal to 4 by 3. So, what is the sum of areas? Sum of areas would be root 3 by 4 times 24 square into 4 by 3. So cancelling this, I get 24 square is 24 into 24. So this is 8. So 24 into 8, 24 into 8 root 3. So I get this value to be 192 root 3. That is option D. So as you could see, this required me to first know the formula for area of an equilateral triangle, and basically know that when you join the midpoints of any triangle, you are going to, by midpoint formula, you're going to be dividing that equilateral triangle into equal parts. So you have half, half, and half each way. So the area of the subsequent triangle would be 1/4 the area of the previous triangle. Do that infinite number of times, you get a GP where the common ratio is 1/4. So using the formula for infinite GP with common ratio 1/4, I calculated what that sum would be. Multiply that with the area of the original triangle, and that way you get the sum of all areas. So you needed to have some basic concepts of triangles as well as some basic concepts of APGP to solve this question. So this is how we solve questions questions or triangles and circles and quadrilaterals, etc. asked. It is very important that you have a very good hold on all the basic fundamental concepts, on all the formulae, and you solve as many questions as possible. So please make sure that you solve all the previous year's papers from CAT, especially the more recent ones, that you have a very good idea about what is the level of difficulty that is asked, what kind of formulas are asked, what kind of how much work is involved in solving all of these questions. The more effort you put in geometry, the more you will be rewarded on actual CAT day. This is one of those topics that responds very well to practice. So please make sure that you build a very strong fundamental in geometry. Keep practicing. Kraku has put up all the most of the CAT previous papers and recent CAT papers for free. So you can solve all questions from that. Also, we have given a lot of questions from our study room for free. So please make sure that you keep practicing questions from all topics so that you have a good handle on basic fundamentals as well as the level of difficulty that is asked in CAT. Thank you for tuning in.